G'day, welcome to Accelerate Maths. Circle graphs are a great way to display data. They look like cheese slices. Circle graphs have other names, sector graphs and pie charts. Today we'll learn the four easy steps to do circle graphs. The first example is about the number of different types of cheese sold in a shop. Step one is to display the data in a table like this. This shop sold 3 Camembert, 2 Cheddar, 4 Feta and 1 Mozzarella cheese. Step 2 is to add these to get the total number of cheeses sold. So 3 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1 adds to a total of 10. In step 3, we calculate the angle that represents the number of the different types of cheese. The rule is the number divided by the total and multiplied by 360 degrees in a circle. This is 3 Camembert out of a total of 10, that's 3/10, multiplied by 360. This equals 108 degrees. There are 2 cheddar out of a total of 10, that's 2/10, multiplied by 360. This equals 72 degrees. For feta, it's 4 out of 10 multiplied by 360 to get 144 degrees. Lastly, for mozzarella, it's 1 divided by 10 multiplied by 360 to get an angle of 36 degrees. Now in step 4, we draw the angles in the circle. First, draw a starting line. The angle for Camembert is 108 degrees. That's a bit larger than a right angle, which is 90 degrees. Using a protractor and a ruler, draw the sector that represents Camembert. This new line is the starting line for the next cheese, that is cheddar. The angle for cheddar is 72 degrees. That's a bit smaller than a right angle of 90 degrees. Using a protractor and a ruler, draw the sector that represents cheddar. Again, this is the starting line for the next cheese, that is feta. The angle for feta is 144 degrees. Now, a right angle is 90 degrees, and two right angles, or a straight line, is 180 degrees. Halfway between these is 135 degrees, which is quite close to the 144 degrees for the feta angle. Using a protractor and a ruler, draw the sector that represents feta. The remaining sector is for mozzarella. Remember to write a title for the circle graph. The final example is about the favourite fruits of the people who were surveyed. Step one is to display the data in a table like this. As their favourite fruit, 7 people chose apple, 3 chose banana, 5 chose mango, 1 said orange, and 4 preferred strawberry. Step 2 is to add these to get the total number of people surveyed. 7 plus 3 plus 5 plus 1 plus 4 adds to a total of 20 people surveyed. In step 3, we calculate the angle that represents the number of people who chose each type of fruit. For apple, 7 out of a total of 20, that's 7/20 of the people surveyed, multiplied by 360, equals 126 degrees. There are 3 banana out of 20, multiplied by 360, this equals 54 degrees. For mango, it's 5 out of 20, multiplied by 360, to get 90 degrees. Only 1 out of the 20 people chose orange, multiply that by 360, to get an angle of 18 degrees. Lastly, for strawberry, it's 4 divided by 20 multiplied by 360 to get an angle of 72 degrees. Now in step 4, we draw the angles in the circle. First, draw a starting line. The angle for apple is 126 degrees. Halfway between a right angle and a straight angle is 135 degrees. And the apple angle is a bit smaller than that. Using a protractor and a ruler, draw the sector that represents apple. this new line becomes the starting line for the next fruit that is banana. The angle for banana is 54 degrees. Now half a right angle is 45 degrees, and the banana angle is slightly larger than that. Using a protractor and a ruler, draw the sector that represents banana. Again, this is the starting line for mango. Well, mango is 90 degrees. That's a right angle. The last angle to measure is 18 degrees for orange. The remaining sector is for strawberry. Once we write a title for the circle graph, we have finished.